How do you get started in data science? That's the question I've been getting a lot of lately. Anyhow, my name is Ryan Swanstrom, and I'm going to answer that question today from my point of view. So, how do you get into data science? I like to say data science has three large pillars. One of them is computer science, one of them is math and statistics, and the other one is domain knowledge. And that comes from Drew Conway's Venn diagram that he made years ago about the three key components of data science and how you use those. And so when I ask and when I talk to people about how to get started in data science, I always look at what are the past skills and knowledge that you have. If you are a software engineer, a software developer, you probably have a good understanding of that computer science programming pillar. If you're coming from a biostatistics or a statistics background, you probably understand the statistics. And maybe you don't always get all the computer science and the programming, but you know a little bit about that statistics. So I always tell people to first focus on what you already know and how it aligns to those three different pillars. And then once you've identified that, pick out areas in the other pillars that you need to work on. And so I'll give you an example from someone who's in the software engineering background, like me. I came from a software developer background into the field of data science. So I had a pretty good understanding of computer science and programming and all the fundamentals and what you can do with computer code and how you can use that. And so I decided to focus a little bit more on the statistics and machine learning portion of that pillar to start building up that knowledge. And then you apply that to domain knowledge. So here's how I frequently answer this question. I ask people if they know how to program. And if they know how to program and are comfortable with that, it doesn't matter even so much which language, whether it's Python or R that you learn first. I would say if you don't know any languages and you want to get into data science, pick one of those two languages. Whichever one you pick isn't super important. Just pick one and start using it and get used to it. But after you know a little bit about that programming language, then start building out some statistics and machine learning knowledge. So go take a course on statistics, go take a course on machine learning, and start building up that skill set. And then once you've got a little bit of computer programming fundamentals and a little bit of statistics and machine learning knowledge, then I tell people it's a great time to start building a project. And I would also say, don't focus on learning everything in statistics, because you'll never learn it all. There's just too much there. And don't focus on learning everything there is to know about computer programming, because it'll just take too long. Get yourself some basics and some fundamentals down in both those, and then start a project. And the reason I say that is because you should start a project in something that you have domain knowledge already in. So you bring in that third pillar from something that you're already interested in and something that you already know about. And if you have a full-time job, it's a great idea to look for something within your existing employer and see if you can find a project there. Or if you're not full-time employed, pick something centered around one of your hobbies. Maybe you like fantasy sports. Maybe you like whatever it is. Maybe you're a cyclist and you can start tracking, how far you cycle every day and, what the weather's like and how does that affect how you cycle. And so that's just what I say. Start focusing on the building up your math and statistics pillar and your computer science pillar. And then build a project where you already have domain knowledge. And as you go along with your project, you'll learn a whole lot of other things, but that's for a different video to talk about. But anyhow, that's just what I wanted to say. That's how I answer that question for a lot of people. Thanks for watching.